Hey guys, it's Bea, and today I just want to talk about some spellcasting basics.
Sorry, the sun is literally going down while I'm filming this, so it's going to get like progressively darker throughout this video. So I'll try and finish this up quick.
Basically, I wanted to make this video because I think it's really helpful to talk about the things that maybe your basic books don't really talk about, because books are being really mass produced right now for people who want to just jump in and start doing spells. So I know information on how to do your basic spell is out there, but the thing that's not really out there is, at least what I have found is not out there enough, is how to do spells and how to prep for your spells and how to do your spells effectively to avoid things going wrong or just to make sure you get the best possible outcome. So I just wanted to cover some basics for you guys and I really hope this helps. So without further ado, let's get started. My first thing that I want to talk about is cleansing. The reason that I think this is so important is because a lot of people know to cleanse, but I don't think something is talked about on how often you should cleanse. And I don't mean like how many days in a row or like once a month. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about items that you buy from a store that you're going to use in your magical practice need to be cleansed. If you get a candle or a crystal or a statue even from a store, from the moment it started being made, energy started to be a part of it. Other people's energy started to come in contact with it and connect with it. So when you bring it back to your house, especially before you use it in any kind of spell work or ritual, you want to make sure that you have cleansed it and gotten all of that energy off of it. Because even if it's not negative energy, it still might not be energy aligned to your purpose. So you can cleanse that at least before you do your spell work. Things that are secondhand. If you thrift a lot, I cleanse everything that I thrift, because that lived with somebody else for an extended period of time or multiple somebody else's. And I thrift a lot because it's cheaper and it's better for the environment. So a lot of things in my house are secondhand. A lot of clothes that I wear are secondhand. Clothes, obviously wash them. That's basic hygiene, but I also cleanse them as well. I wanna get any energy that's not my energy off of it. Even if you order something online, you wanna make sure that you cleanse that too, because although it does not come in contact with as much energy as something in a store would come in contact with, it still comes in contact with the manufacturers, the people who box it, the people who ship it. So I highly stress to cleanse all items that you're gonna use in your magical work. And then any items that you buy secondhand, or if you can just feel that there's something not right with it, give it a good cleansing. I am an empath, so this is kind of like extra big. If you are an empath too, I'm sure you know cleansing can help so much. And it's hard to be an empath and like to thrift. It's really difficult. But with cleansing, that can help, and I can in that way get things and hopefully not have any issues with them. All right, so now we're gonna go over some basic ways that you can cleanse things. These aren't necessarily all the ways. They're just kind of the big basic ways, the easy ways, and the most common ways, and the ways that I use. So number one is smoke cleanse, which is probably what you think of. You can do herb bundles, you can do it with incense. There's loads of different herbs that you can use for a good smoke cleanse. Pulling hair in front of my face. There's loads of different herbs that you can use for a good smoke cleanse, as well as incense. You can use things like frankincense, myrrh, sage, cedar, rosemary, just to name a few. There's a ton more though. I can do a whole video on cleansing if you guys want a little bit more in depth. Just let me know down below or give this video a thumbs up. Another way that you can cleanse is water. You can put things under running water because the energy of the water coming out of your faucet could help. Or if you live close enough to natural water, if you want to cleanse in there, then by all means cleanse it in that water. I will say, just so you guys know, not all crystals can go in water. It can damage certain crystals. I don't know off the top of my head what crystals can and cannot. Definitely just Google it, find out what crystal you're trying to cleanse, Google it, see if it can go into the water. And not all crystals can go into the sun. I didn't really talk about sun cleansing in my list. I probably should have, because that's a really easy way. You can cleanse by the sun, That can harm some crystals too, cleansing by the sun.
Hey guys, it's Editing Bee here, and really quick on the screen, I just wanted to throw up some crystals that can't go in water and can't go in the sun. Definitely double check before you put something in the sun. This might not be a totally comprehensive list, but I did want to give you some of the basics. Okay, now back to the video.
And then last for cleansing, what I'm going to talk about is sound. You can use bells, singing bowls, or even music. And just cleanse things by sound. I personally, this is my least favorite way to do it. For me, it just doesn't do it for me, but I know a lot of people who prefer to cleanse by sound. Now, there is a question about how often you should cleanse. Really, it's just up to the practitioner, especially when it comes to things like your house or supplies that you already have. You know, you can cleanse once a week, every day, once a month. Personally, I do a big cleansing of my whole house every full moon. That's just what works best for me. The times that I cleanse other than that are when I purchase new items or if I just feel like I need to shake a room up a little bit. One thing that I do think should be said is to always, always, always cleanse your space before spell work. And you wanna, or just ritual, even if you're having a ritual without a certain spell. This is really important because stale energy can build up, especially if you're doing it inside, and you don't want that energy in your ritual. You do want to cleanse your space to get any stale, negative, or even positive energies that just don't align with what you're working with. You want to get all those out. You want to make sure it's a clean area. You also want to cleanse yourself. Another thing that you want to cleanse is stuff that you maybe haven't used in a while. So before I do any sort of spell work or ritual, I cleanse the room that I'm working in. And I also, if I'm using an item that maybe I don't use every time I do spell work, I cleanse that as well. For example, I don't use my tarot cards as much as some witches do. I need to learn how to read tarot better. That's not something that I'm excellent at. So I don't use my tarot cards a lot. So I cleanse my tarot cards a lot because just stale energy is not energy that you want around things that you're doing for magic. So if I'm using my tarot cards, I'll do a quick, I like to cleanse with smoke. I'll do some quick smoke over my tarot cards or any other item that I just haven't used in a while. So you always want to cleanse your space, yourself, and your items before spell work. We're going to talk about intention. Intention setting is really important, and I feel like a lot of books that I have read haven't necessarily covered intention setting the way that I think that some other ones that I have read have covered it. Because a lot of misconceptions that I have found in my personal practice, especially when I first started, was that you can just go in, throw your things together, do your spell, and then you're done. When really, especially if you're using herbs that or crystals, they can be used, one herb can be used for so many different things. Cinnamon, for example, is like the best herb because it can be used for protection, for prosperity, for love. It can be used for so many things. So if you're using cinnamon in a protection working, you don't really need the prosperity part of cinnamon. So you need to set your intention with the cinnamon, and you can do this however you want. I like to just hold it in my hands and set the intention. You can write something out to say for each herb, like I set this cinnamon with the intention of prosperity. And then you put it into whatever you're working on. Sometimes I'll kind of say something, I'll murmur it, but sometimes I'll just kind of hold my hands over it and push the intention out through my hands and into the herb that or crystal that I am working with that needs to be charged with a certain intention. And then the other thing about intentions is the intention behind your spell. It needs to be clear, and you need to make sure that you understand it yourself. And what I mean by that is like, don't use big words that you don't know or like magical terms that you don't know or a different language that you don't know. Because as cool as it would be to say spells in a different language, if you are not 100% fluent, you could accidentally mess something up and not truly know what you're saying. So obviously it is your practice. You can do absolutely whatever you want, but I would advise against using words that you're not 100% familiar with because you never know what could accidentally come out of that. You also want to make your intention for your spell possible. With magic, you have to have some kind of a possibility for this to be happening. So an example of something that wouldn't be possible, it's not going to happen for you, is like, let's say that I cast a spell and that I wanted to move to California and live in a mansion by the end of the year. I currently live in Missouri, and because of COVID-19, I'm currently 100% unemployed. And it's August. That's not gonna happen. So set your intention and make your intention clear. All right, and now we're gonna talk about visualization. So for visualization, this is something that was hard for me and still I do struggle with. It's hard for me to see things in my mind's eye the way that I wish that I could. But the reason that visualization is so important is because it helps when you do your spell to make your body, make your mind feel like it's already done. The best example that I can give is, let's say you have your student loans and you want to pay your student loans off. So you do a spell to help maybe pay them off faster. When you're doing your spell, visualize that elated feeling that you would have when they're all paid off. Make yourself believe that it's already happened, because truly when you start your spell, it's already done. You're doing it, you're working on it. Obviously, you still have to make steps and make sure you're doing your part of the spell too, but that's how manifestation is most effective, is when you tell yourself that I already have this, this is already done. That's why a lot of times in manifestation, when you read about that, people will say, don't use I want to be happy, say I am happy. Because when you say I want to be happy or I wish I was happy, that's just you confirming that you are not happy. So you should say that you already are happy. And that helps your mind, which then helps your intention. All right, and lastly, we are going to talk about grounding. For grounding, this is going to help your whole spell entirely, because it's going to make sure that you are centered. And you can ground in a couple of different ways. You can just take deep breaths. You can do meditation. You can take a shower, and a shower would be a double whammy, because you can cleanse yourself in the shower and you can ground yourself in the shower. Do something that's calming for you. If you like to play an instrument or if you like to write poems, maybe do that before you're working, so you are calm, centered, and grounded. And that's going to help you really push the correct intentions and reach the right visualization that you're trying to get for your spell. All right, you guys, that is it for today. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions at all, please leave them down below and I will be happy to answer them. And I would very much appreciate it if you would subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. That means a ton to me. And my Instagram and my Witchy Shop Instagram are both linked down below as well. All right, you guys, that is all I have for you today. Blessed be.